the Yanks, back to America from the battlefields of Europe and Africa. Foot soldiers and tankmen and airmen and gunners, veterans of the Tunisian desert, of the beachheads of Italy and Normandy, of skies over Germany, the mountains of Tuscany, the mud of France. A great city greets the battle-weary soldiers. America is looking toward this port of debarkation as these 15,000 more of her gallant sons come home from Europe's battlefronts. Now the thoughts of the fighting man are flying past the tall buildings toward another town, one that means home somewhere in the great heart of America. And there will be someone waiting, a reception committee of the most important people on earth. With a soldier, even though he is your father. And then at last, home. That most longed for spot on earth. The vision that filled the soldier's dreams through long, weary months. The symbol of all he fought for. Beautiful, peaceful, secure. A place to rest and restore faith. But for a man, home is more than an ivory tower. It's part of a street, and the street leads to friends, neighbors, a community. He wants to revisit familiar places. He wants to know how his hometown folks have been looking after things while he's been away. For instance, is that Kelly hoeing his beans? Hey, Kelly! Who's that? Joe! Well, by golly, now there's a sight for sore eyes. Welcome home, neighbor. Welcome home. Oh, we've been carrying on here. Victory garden. Yes, sir. Beans, lettuce, tomatoes. It's the home front, you know. Not much compared with what you've been doing, but the best we can. Well, Joe, it's good to see you around again. Yes, this is the home front. This street of neighbors. A patch of green lawn. Little children growing up straight and strong in the sunshine with good food, healthful surroundings, a place to play, and the loving care of their elders. This is childhood's birthright in America. But as the soldier looks, his mind goes back to other scenes. To children of a war-torn land who might have starved but for the generosity of hometown America. The homeless ones, victims of a war that never was of their own choosing, refugees from disaster. To these, the people of America are sending food, medicine, clothing through their National War Fund. To a dozen war-torn countries of Europe, to the Philippines, to China. He remembers a child to whom a piece of bread was the thing almost too wonderful to believe. And a child whose birthright seemed to be only terror, hunger, misery. But other scenes bring brighter memories. This USO club, a home away from home to the men and women of America's armed forces, and everyone the gift of hometown folks through the National War Fund. Today, one finds there men who bear the scars of battle. Today, the 2,500 USO clubs have a new and important job to do for convalescents and for men returning from war. USO camp shows that the home folks are now sending to hospitals, to the Pacific, and to men still in Europe. The best of American entertainment. And he recalls how the home folks provided the United Seamen Service for the gallant men of the Merchant Marine, a home and club in ports around the earth. These are the crews who carried men to every invasion beach, the crews who will bring our soldiers home. Rest homes, where merchant seamen can recover from convoy fatigue. Through war prisoners' aid, the home folks have stood by their boys even in the prison camps of the enemy. Indeed, your Community War Fund gift goes to work around the world. Through the National War Fund, and provides community chest, red feather services here at home. Wholesome, healthful surroundings like these for children while their mothers are at work. This is not only an act of giving, but a community investment in its own safety, its own future, from which everybody benefits. Safeguarding the health of a baby during those first, most perilous days of his life. And the health of his mother during the time of her confinement. Clinics to guard the health of every individual, knowing how important this is to all the rest of us. Foster homes for children who need the shelter and loving care and guidance only a home can give. A visiting nurse, sent as the community's ambassador of hygiene and health into homes like this to combat illness or to assuage pain. Agencies, giving boys and girls their chance to serve too on the home front as couriers and messengers, bearers of burdens, taking on duties important to our time, doing them faithfully, cheerfully, and well. Today the soldier finds his community alert to the needs of the hour, preparing to help him through this information and advisory service for veterans. A big job today, a bigger one tomorrow. Yes, here come the Yanks. Soon, millions more will be coming home from every battlefront. They fought to make the world a place where mankind can live in peace and brotherhood. And they have a right to expect that you will make America the kind of land they have been fighting for. That through the National War Fund, you will stand by those still in uniform at home and overseas. That you will continue to send food, clothing, medicine to our allies in war-torn lands. Let us give to the Community War Fund freely, thankfully. Thus, we who have not known the pain of battle can better share the pride of victory.